Hello everyone, good morning to all. I am Ankita Bhagat, your science teacher from Sahajanand English Medium School at Nathdwej. So students, after completion of chapter, now we will start the explanation of exercise question answer. Let us start. Here the question number first, that is, classify the changes involved in following process as physical change or chemical change. So here some examples is given to you. So we have to classify which one is the physical change and which one is the chemical change. Now let us discuss. See here, the first one is the photosynthesis process. So do you know photosynthesis process is physical change or chemical change? So I think you know about that, the physical change and chemical change. The physical change is temporary and reversible, whereas the chemical change is permanent change, right? In that there are one or more new substances formed, but in physical change the new substance are not formed, there are no new substance are formed, right? So let us discuss. Now see the first one, photosynthesis process. So photosynthesis process is physical change or chemical change? But obviously it is physical change, because a new substance is formed in that, right? So the photosynthesis is chemical change. Now the next one is dissolving sugar in water. Dissolving sugar in water is the physical change, because through the distillation process we again get back the sugar from the sugar solution. That's why dissolving sugar in water is a physical change. Now next we have, that is burning of coal. Burning of coal is a chemical change, because it is not reversible. If one time the coal is burned, now we get only ash, right? So it is not reversible. That's why we can say that the burning of coal is a chemical change, right? Now the next we have, that is melting of wax. So melting of wax is a physical change. So through the melting of wax we again get the wax. Here the property of wax is not changed, only the physical state change, right? So we can say that the melting of wax is a physical change. Now next one is the beating aluminium to make aluminium foil. Beating aluminium to make aluminium foil, this is also the physical change, right? Because the aluminium is constant, aluminium is not changed. If we beating the aluminium, the property of aluminium is same, right? So that's why it is the physical change. Now next one is the digestion of food. The digestion of food is the chemical change. Got it? Now the second question is true and false. So the first one, in that cutting a log of wood into the pieces is a chemical change. So answer is no. The cutting a log of wood into the pieces, it is the physical change, because we only cut the wood in the pieces. The property of wood is not changed here, only the physical state is changed, right? So that's why the answer is false here, because the cutting of log of wood is the physical change. Now the second question, in that formation of manure from leaves is a physical change. So the formation of the manure from the leaves is the chemical change. That's why here answer is false, right? Third one, iron pipe coated with the zinc do not get rusted easily. Yes, if iron pipe coated with the zinc, or if you are painting to the iron pipe, it do not get rusted easily, right? So the answer is true. Now the fourth one is that iron and rust both are same substance. Iron and rust both are same substance. So we already discussed in chapter that iron and rust both are different substance, because the rust of iron is the oxide of iron, and the chemical formula of oxide of iron is Fe2O3, right? So that's why they both are the different substance. We cannot say the iron and rust both are the same substance. So the answer is here false, right? Now condensation of a steam is not a chemical change. Yes, it is not a chemical change, it is a physical change, right? So if we boil the water and we again bake the liquid through the condensation process, so that's why it is a physical change, it is not a chemical change, right? So the answer is true. Now the next is fill in the blanks in the following statements, right? So fill in the blanks. When carbon dioxide is passed through the lime water, it turns milky due to the formation of, again I repeat, the carbon dioxide passed through the lime water. It turns milky due to the formation of calcium carbonate. So we already learned in activity 6.8. In this chapter, activity 6.8, we already learned due to the formation of calcium carbonate. Right? Now, the chemical formula of calcium carbonate is CaCO3. Right? Now, the next question in that, the chemical name of baking soda is, the chemical name of baking soda is sodium hydrogen carbonate. Remember it. It is important for your MCQ question and the blanks also, right? Now, the chemical name of baking soda is sodium hydrogen carbonate. And the chemical formula of calcium baking soda is NaHCO3. Remember it. It is important for your MCQ question, right? Now the next question is, two methods by which rusting of iron can be prevented are, that is painting and the coated of zinc, that is galvanization, right? There are the two methods we prevent the rusting of iron. The first method is painting and the second method is galvanization. Now the next one is, changes in which only the properties of substance change are called physical changes. So changes in which only the physical property. So if the changes in physical property of substance changes called the physical change. Now the next is, changes in which new substance are formed. So changes in that there are one or more new substance are formed, that is called chemical change. This is the definition of chemical change, right? So these are the blanks. Now the next question is, when baking soda, sodium hydrogen carbonate, the chemical name of the baking soda is sodium hydrogen carbonate and the chemical formula is NaHCO3. Again, I repeat, when baking soda is mixed with lemon juice, the bubbles are formed with the evolution of gas. Now, what type of change is it? Explain. So, when baking soda is mixed with the lemon juice, in activity 6.8, we mix with the baking soda which substance? So, vinegar. We add the vinegar with the baking soda. So same here, the lemon juice is the acidic solution and at that time the vinegar also the acidic solution, right? So baking soda is mixed with the lemon juice, bubbles are formed with the evolution of gas. Now, what type of change is it? But obvious, it is chemical change. Now, let us see. When baking soda is mixed with the lemon juice, here the equation also given. When the baking soda add with the lemon juice, bubbles are formed with the evolution of carbon dioxide. Bubbles are formed with the evolution of carbon dioxide gas. So, this change is the chemical change. And the other substance also formed. And you know very well, what are the definition of the chemical change? In that, there are the one or more new substances are formed is called chemical change. Here also the new substance is formed. That's why here the chemical change. Right? Now the question number 5. When a candle burns, both physical and chemical changes take place. Identify these changes and give another example of familiar process in which both the chemical and physical change are takes place. Right? So when candle burns, both physical and chemical change are take place. Let us discuss how. See, when a candle burns, first of all, the wax melts. So when we provide the heat to candle, at that time candle burns. And first of all, wax is melt. Then after melting of wax is a physical change. Why? Because we again get back the wax, from the melting of wax. So the melted wax burns by the reacting with the oxygen and the carbon dioxide gas is produced. So when it burns, reacting with the oxygen, in the presence of oxygen, when it burns, the carbon dioxide gas is produced. The carbon dioxide gas is liberated. So this change is chemical change. That's why we can say that in the candle, there are the both changes takes place, chemical change and the physical change. Right? So thus, two changes are found during the burning of candle. Now another example is heating of sulfur. When sulfur is heated, the first of all, it melts from liquid sulfur. So when we heat the sulfur, it converts into the liquid sulfur. So this is the physical change because we again get back the sulfur from that. It is the reversible process. That's why it is the physical change. On heating liquid sulfur, further, it gets converted into the gaseous form and burned to form sulfur dioxide. So, this is the chemical change. So, that's why we can say that in sulfur also, there are the both physical and chemical change take place. Right? Now, the question number 6. Question 6. How would you show that the setting of curd is a chemical change? Let us see. The setting of curd is a chemical change because curd cannot be turned back into the milk. It is not reversible process. So the chemical change is not reversible. It is permanent change. Right? So that's why the setting of curd is the chemical change. Again see, the setting of curd is a chemical change because curd cannot be turned back into milk. So, the property of milk and the curd both are different. It is not reversible process. That's why we can say that the setting of curd is chemical change. Right? Now, the next we have that is question number 7. Explain why burning of wood and cutting it into the small pieces are considered as the two different type of changes. Why? Let us discuss. Now, cutting of wood is a physical change because if you cut the wood, you again get back the wood. Here, the physical property is not changed. Here, the physical property of wood is not changed. Only the pieces is increased. Right? So, that's why cutting of wood is a physical change. But the burning of wood is the chemical change. How? Let us see. So, on the other hand, burning of wood is a chemical change As wood is converted to charcoal, because the wood is converted to charcoal, there are the new substances formed. Right? So that's why it is the cutting of wood is the physical change, where burning of wood is the chemical change. Remember it. Now question number 8. Describe how crystal of copper sulfate are prepared. So here activity is given to you, that is also given in your textbook. Now let us write the process. So crystal of copper sulfate are prepared using the crystallization method. Now which is described as follows, one by one given. Take a cup full of water in beaker. First of all, take a cup full of water in a beaker. I already explained you. Again, I explained, right? Now, add a few drops of dilute sulfuric acid into this. Now, heat the water and when it starts boiling, add copper sulfate powder while still stirring, right? And add the copper sulfate powder till the solution become settled, right? Now, filter into the china dish and allow it to cool. And the solution should be kept undistributed and slowly the crystal of copper sulfate separate out. The crystal of copper sulfate is prepared. Right? Now the question number 9, explain how painting of an iron gate prevent it from rusting. Solution is given. See, so rusting of iron requires only contact with water or moisture, contact with water and oxygen. That's why by painting an iron gate, we prevent the contact between iron, oxygen and water. So if we painting the iron gate or any iron article, we prevent the contact between oxygen and moisture, oxygen and water. So that's why this help in preventing the rusting of iron. Now the next question is, explain why rusting of iron object is faster in coastal area than in desert. Why? Because rusting of iron acquires contact with water and oxygen. Again, I repeat, rusting of iron required contact with moisture and oxygen. In coastal area, the humidity is more as compared to desert area, right? So hence, rusting of iron is faster in coastal area than deserts. Right? Now here one MCQ is given to you. Let us see. The gas we use in kitchen is called liquefied petroleum gas and the short form is LPG. So the gas we used in kitchen is LPG and the full form is liquefied petroleum gas. Remember it. It is important for your MCQ question, right? So in the cylinder, it exists as a liquid. When it comes out from the cylinder, it becomes gas. Here change A, and then it burns. It is change B. The following statement pertain to these changes and choose the correct one. So here change A and change B given to you, and you have to say that the change A is physical change or chemical change, or change B is physical change or chemical change. So again I repeat question. The gas we use in kitchen is called LPG, and in the cylinder it exists as a liquid, and when it's come out from the cylinder it become gas. So the change A. Now, what are the change A? द लिक्विड फॉर्म गैस इज कन्वर्ट इनटू द गैसियस फॉर्म. इट इज द चेंज ए इज फिजिकल चेंज और केमिकल चेंज. नाउ देन आफ्टर देन एलपीजी द लिक्विड फॉर्म और गैसियस फॉर्म इज बर्न्स. दिस इज द चेंज बी इज केमिकल चेंज और फिजिकल चेंज. नाउ लेट अस डिस्कस. सो हियर चेंज ए इज इंडिकेट दैट ओनली एलपीजी गैस इज लिक्विड स्टेट इन सिलेंडर एंड व्हेन इट कम्स आउट फ्रॉम द सिलेंडर इट बिकम गैस. सो इट मीन्स इट इज फिजिकल चेंज फ्रॉम लिक्विड टू गैस. सो हियर चेंज ए इज अ फिजिकल चेंज. इट इज नॉट अ केमिकल चेंज. राइट. सो इन दैट ऑप्शन ए इज अ केमिकल चेंज. ए इज अ फिजिकल चेंज इज नॉट गिवन. नाउ अगेन सी. सो व्हेन इट बर्न. नाउ इन सेकेंड प्रोसेस बी द एलपीजी इज बर्न देन कन्वर्ट टू द अदर गैसेस. इट कन्वर्ट टू द अदर गैसेस. द अदर गैसेस इज फॉर्म्ड सच इज कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड. सो हियर न्यू सब्सटेंसेस इज फॉर्म्ड इन प्रोसेस बी. सो वी कैन से दैट द प्रोसेस बी इज अ केमिकल चेंज. सो प्रोसेस ए इज अ फिजिकल चेंज एंड प्रोसेस बी इज अ केमिकल चेंज. नाउ लेट अस सी इन ऑप्शंस. सो ऑप्शन ए इज अ प्रोसेस ए इज अ केमिकल चेंज. सो आंसर इज रॉन्ग. प्रोसेस बी इज अ केमिकल चेंज. यस द प्रोसेस बी इज अ केमिकल चेंज. नाउ ऑप्शन सी बोथ प्रोसेस ए एंड बी आर केमिकल चेंज. नाउ दिस वन इज रॉन्ग. नाउ द फोर्थ वन इज नन ऑफ प्रोसेस इज केमिकल चेंज. सो दिस वन इज ऑल्सो रॉन्ग. नाउ वॉट इज द राइट आंसर. द ऑप्शन बी इज द राइट आंसर. ओनली प्रोसेस बी इज अ केमिकल चेंज. राइट. नाउ द नेक्स्ट वी हैव दैट इज एनएरोबिक बैक्टीरिया डाइजेस्ट एनिमल वेस्ट एंड प्रोड्यूस बायोगैस. हियर द चेंज ए इज द केमिकल चेंज और फिजिकल चेंज. फर्दर वी डिस्कस. फर्स्ट सी द क्वेश्चन अगेन. आई रिपीट द एनएरोबिक बैक्टीरिया डाइजेस्ट एनिमल वेस्ट एंड प्रोड्यूस बायोगैस. सो द बायोगैस इज देन बर्नड एज द फ्यूल. द चेंज बी. सो चेंज बी इज व्हेन द बायोगैस बर्न्स इट इज द फिजिकल चेंज और केमिकल चेंज. नाउ फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट पर्टेन टू दीज चेंजेस. चूज द करेक्ट ऑप्शन. अगेन वी से दैट the change a is a physical change or chemical change and the change b is the physical change or chemical change. Right. So anaerobic bacteria, it means what? In the absence of oxygen the bacteria decompose dead and decaying animal waste and it produce the biogas. It is the chemical change. So absence of oxygen, the bacteria decompose dead and decaying animal waste to produce biogas. It is the chemical change. So we can say that the change A is the chemical change. Now again here biogas is burn. Again here biogas is burn as a fuel. Same as the LPG. Right? Again biogas is burn as a fuel. It is also a chemical change. So therefore here process A and process B both are chemical change. Now let us see in a option. So option A is a process A is a chemical change. Yes, process A is a chemical change but process B also chemical change. Right. Now option B, process B is a chemical change. Yes, process B is a chemical change but A is not consider. So we cannot consider this option. Now option C is both process A and B are chemical change. Yes, the answer is C. Both process A and B are chemical changes. Right. So these are the right answer. So students, complete the exercise in your notebook. Now next video we will upload in next session with new chapter. Thank you. Have a nice day.